Yo, what is slurping on? Young HP Steel Gyarados here, back with another ADV narration. Today we got a loading from Team Brazil versus PDC from, if I recall correctly, it's Team US Northeast, but if that's wrong, I'm just a noob idiot, I guess. But we're going to playoffs for the World Cup of Pokemon right now, so I don't think I would be recording any of these other games from the group stage. This game looked quite fun, though, so we see a Celebi from Alolan side leading off versus PDC's Skarmory. So the Skarmory can just go get up a spike. Alolan could definitely have a Magneton in the back, though. Celebi kind of likes Magneton, removing some of these steals that have been weakened, especially if it is some form of offensive Celebi. But, so he definitely could have Magneton, so PDC could go for either a spike or a double switch. If he has a double, that could cover the Celebi staying in and going for... Well, yeah, Celebi doesn't really like to stay in on Skarmory, especially if he doesn't have a spinner in the back, because that's just free spikes for sure. Because, like, the Celebi can't really do too much. HP Fire doesn't do too much to Skarmory. Lichee isn't going to affect it too hard. But yeah, spikes is a bit of a risky play. PDC could definitely make that play just to get up a free spike. We'll see what he wants to do. Obviously, if it is leftovers Magneton, unless the meta has shifted and this is completely unfactual information, but from what I know, if it's leftovers Magneton, Skarmory has a chance to live that. So if PDC gets extremely lucky, he can get up two spikes. Or if it's like some fast Skarmory, which is kind of cool. I've seen that a couple times already. That's a really cool set. If he's like fast Skarmory to outspeed Magneton, he can definitely get a few more spikes up as well. So he gets up a spike, or does he? Yeah, okay, he does get up a spike. So that's pretty nice. If this Magneton is faster than Skarmory, you can just one-shot him, especially if it's Magneton, which I haven't seen too much lately, but that's definitely still nice to ensure that one-shot on Skarmory and just do more damage to other shit like Metagross as well. So we'll see what he wants to do. So it is a fast Skarmory. Okay, I was just like completely guessing sets, but dude, I feel like Docker should have I have the power of everything in my hands. So he gets up three spikes here because he actually gets the roll and lives that T-bolt. So extremely, I mean not extremely lucky, but that's quite lucky. I don't know the roll exactly. So oh, a Dugtrio. That's kind of disgusting because now the Magneton is gone. Although I don't know if the Magneton would have done too much, but obviously just getting a free trap on a Pokemon is really nice. This Dugtrio could be an issue for the Celebi as well, especially with spikes up. But spikes is gonna get chipped in the range of Bandit HP Bug very, very fast. So yeah, if it doesn't have Recover, the Celebi is gonna get chipped into range very fast. So the Skarmory can just go for a spike, because it's very unlikely that the third Pokemon would be a Magneton, because that just doesn't really look right. That nice double trap plus double steal. I don't know. On his team, it doesn't really look like a Magneton would fit. So he goes in a Gengar. This could be either Taunt Gengar or something with like T-Bolt or Fire Punch to hit the Skarmory. But Fire Punch doesn't do too much because that attack is piss weak. Now, Alolan should switch, I think, because he definitely needs to scout for Taunt. And T-Bolt, Skarmory doesn't appreciate T-Bolt either. Although, there's a kind of a good opportunity to get up a spike. If he has Protect, he could definitely click it. I don't really see what would hold him back from clicking that, unless it's like sub Gengar, the fattest onset of the century. But I don't know, like, there's nothing really holding him back from hitting Protect, just to scout out the set. Maybe it's Taunt, maybe it is T-Bolt. If it just only has Fire Punch, he might just go for spikes after, because with Protect spikes, he can actually keep Skarmory quite healthy. Obviously, if PDC has something in the back, oh yeah, he just goes Celebi, which does kind of make sense on the Taunt. If it was Fire Punch, I don't even know if that's in range, because again, Fire Punch is piss weak. That would depend on the sets on both the Gengar and the Celebi. If it's like a fat Spidef Celebi, it would probably eat two Fire Punch from that range, because it's stab. It has like 75 base power, I think. So it doesn't do shit. After the next round of spikes, though, the Celebi doesn't really like switching into the Gengar anymore. But yeah, Gengar's obviously scared of the Psychic right here. Gyarados can't switch in, so we'll see what the next Pokemon is. If it's another Steel, he can switch that in. Oh, if it's a... oh, yes, let's go. We see a Blissey. So we do see a double from Alolan. That's a really, really good double into Skarmory to get up these other spikes. He really needs to start pressuring because he already has three spikes up. Now, I don't know what he would switch in, if he would even switch anything in. Obviously, because of the Taunt, he doesn't want to stay in. He could, if he has an attack move, he could stay in and click that, but that doesn't do too much to the Gengar because Skarmory is kind of weak. But yeah, I don't know what his switching would be, because if the Celebi gets hit by the Fire Punch on the switching, it's dead, and you don't want the Celebi just dying. Although Celebi doesn't really look like it does too much, it can definitely get the Lead Sheet on the Blissey, scare this Gengar out. But he should have something else for the Gengar, at least. Magneton obviously gone right now, so it can't really switch in, although it wouldn't appreciate a Fire Punch, definitely not with all those spikes up. So yeah, the Skarmory's scared as fuck. I don't know, he's gonna reveal something. Obviously, if he has a ground type, he could switch that in, but that would depend on the ground type. Actually, that's actually a fat lag, because ground types actually don't like switching to Gengar. I don't know what the fuck I'm saying, especially not if it's something like a Swampert that could get Giga Drained upon. But I definitely think B2C's team is the most filthy thing I've ever seen in a long while. Like, what is this? This looks like some ultra filth. So he actually does just decide to stay in with the Skarmory and risk it, which is a really good... Damn, Alone's been playing this like a beast. Damn, Alone the Skarmory champion, that's fire. So he reveals that he is an attacking moveset, and he goes to that Jotpack, which actually does quite a lot to the Gengar. Black Sludge is gonna... I mean, Black Sludge, okay, what am I saying? The Leftovers are gonna... I'm thinking in the future, no. But the Leftovers are gonna heal him up a little bit, especially because the Skarmory is basically forced out right now. Because his Gengar could fire off a fat, super effective attack. Celebi doesn't want to switch in for the reasons I stated before. So let's see what Illaoidin has for the switch in. But that was amazingly played. Getting it in on the double, then predicting P2C to double out and getting up that extra spike. That was actually, yeah, that was like really goaty. So we'll see what he has in store for us. Maybe a Blissey. A Blissey would make me quite happy. Nice Blissey with some move to hit this Gengar for some nice damage. So yeah, Blissey would make me really happy. We see Blissey on Blissey action. Imagine if Alone just whips out the Blissey and then PDC also goes into his Blissey and they just start CMing up on each other. Oh, that would be amazing. But yeah, in real talk, I don't know what Alone would switch into this. Can't really guess team structure from this. And of course, this is ADV, so I can't be like Dockridge. Oh, he could make this play and he can make this play. I'm not on that level. But he does go into Tyranitar, which is cool. The Willows gets thrown off, so that's kind of, I was going to say a risky play, but nobody would go Celebi there. So I guess Willowisp would hit every single switch in. It does reveal the T-Tar here, so this could have Pursuit. I don't know if Gengar is even in range of Pursuit. I'm not too sure. But that would depend on the Gengar, but most of these Gengars run some fat, so he can slurp up a Pursuit. I don't know if it, actually I don't know if it's in range. If P2C is really the greatest to ever do it, he just stays in right here and just hits that T-Tar with a fat attack. He hits it with a T-Ball. Oh, that's disgusting. Oh, that's not good at all. Now he can 2KO him. Oh, that's really filthy. Damn, of course crits do double damage in this generation, so that's like ultra filth. Yeah, holy shit, that's really, really disgusting. But yeah, the Pursuit, looking from the damage, it probably wouldn't have killed. Maybe it would have with the, maybe it would have with the sand, but it wouldn't take sand damage. So yeah, it probably wouldn't have killed. So, I don't know, I guess it was still the correct play, but yeah, P2C definitely caught him right there. So the Aerodactyl comes in. He hasn't really revealed an Aerodactyl switch in yet. If his Bucket Water is a nice Swampert or something, he can switch in a couple times. But with all these spikes up, especially if Aerodactyl hits HP flying here, it doesn't really, or even Double Edge on the Gengar if he's real goat. Okay, JK, that's a fat umplay. But even if he hits HP flying and the Swampert comes out with the spikes and everything, that does get chipped. Double Ground wouldn't really make too much sense. But Swampert's nice and disgusting. A Suicune on this team, like a nice rest Suicune to fit on this like kind of stally place, that would kind of make sense, but it is the Swampert that does come out. As the HP flying comes out, oh, that's the reverse crit. Holy shit, that's really disgusting. Oh, that's filthy. So he protects up. I still don't think if he gets a double protect, is he in range? I actually don't know if he's in range. I think it's a roll if he gets a double protect, so I assume he's just going to try to go for that because he hasn't really revealed another switch in. If he does have a T-Tar in the back or something like that, he might just want to go and switch into T-Tar right now because HP flying doesn't do too much, although it is obviously banded, so it does some chip, plus with these spikes. I don't know head calc or rolls because I'm not some ultra god, so I wouldn't know if T-Tar is the play if he does have that, or yeah, I don't know what his last would be. T-Tar does make kind of sense in a way. But yeah, I don't know if he would want to switch that in, because Swampert is low. Swampert's going to die to spikes anyway. I think going for the double protect is the play here. It doesn't even matter what his last is. Double protect is, yeah, in my opinion, always the play. Oh, never mind. We don't know. It's 25%, right? So it could still live spiked. Only P2C knows that, because Sharon sometimes bugs. This could be 24 HP or 25.1% or something, which means it would be able to survive spikes. But yeah, only P2C knows the exact HP. Illaoidin is obviously just going to HP flying. It's his only play. And I assume P2C is just going to go for that double protect and see if he can get that to at least get some revenge for that filthy crit. Although kind of, he also got the T-Ball crit on T-Tar, so I don't know, I guess it's kind of some revenge. P2C, I think, is making some expert calculations to see if HP flying, or if switching into his switch-in, if he even has one. But I assume Skarmory is not going to be your only Aerodactyl switch-in. And if it is, I don't think going for hard spikes or normal wants to play. But he's probably calculating right now to see if Double Protect is the play. I don't know what his last would be. And obviously, I don't have the calculator on hand because I'm not going to make some boring calc. So he does go for the double protect. At least he tries to go for the double protect and he fails to get it. So rest in peace of Revenge Hacks. His last is a T-Tar. So T-Tar was probably just not to play then. It is a leftover T-Tar, so no Lumberry DD set. Oh, there's the Revenge Hacks. Oh, there it is. That's disgusting. I don't think... yeah, it's definitely out of range. Earthquake. So T-Tar still needs to switch out. I assume... this is actually kind of a 50-50 toss-up, although, in my opinion, Blissey is always the play from PTC. He could go hard into Gengar on the EQ if he really wants to predict that and really wants to be the GOAT, because this is still anyone's game, in my opinion. So, although, yeah, no, I think this is anyone's game, although Alolan is kind of on the upper hand right now. But yeah, he does go hard into Blissey. This is going to take a lot from EQ if he does go for that. He can't obviously beat it one-on-one, unless some massive hacks happens. But the Swampert can get a lot of HP back in the turns that PDC goes for the soft-boiled, so he can just start fishing for that. And obviously PDC can't pivot into Gengar right now, because then he just loses Blissey, then he just loses to Pert in the long run. That's yeah, that's obviously not the play. I don't even know why I started talking about that. But Alolan can just start spamming EQ right now, as he gets a kind of low roll right there. But yeah, as I said, he can start spamming EQ and get some easy lefties here. I assume PDC is going to soft build up again. Alolan should just EQ again. Now this Blissey has some comfortable HP, so he can start firing off an attack, although an Ice Beam or something like that wouldn't do too much to the Pert, as he does have the Toxic, so he goes to the Toxic on the Pert. He can beat it 1-1-1 pretty comfortably now. No leftovers or anything for the Swampert. Some soft boats got stalled out. I guess Alolan could have gone Skarmory on the Pert, but then he risks the Fire Blast just coming out the turn after. So actually, this Blissey, I don't know, I was saying that Alolan had the upper hand, but this Blissey is still a big threat, although he does obviously have an Aerodactyl. But I don't know the headcalx from Aerodactyl on Blissey. I think he needs the flinch here. We've seen this before. I remember in SPL we've seen this before. An Aerodactyl flinching through everything. But yeah, I said Alolan had the upper hand, but yeah, I don't know. That's not really true. I shouldn't talk too much. I'm just some noob idiot. Shout out to the godset Aiden Power Steel Gyarados. Just trying to get some like average quality content that anyone with a bit of ADV knowledge could make out for you guys, and trying to make it like a bit more entertaining. Where I lack skill, I hope I at least have some entertainment. But I think Rock Slide is the play here, depending on how much Double Edge does. But assume Double Edge is around like. It does around like 50 to 55. I don't know how much it does. I might be overestimating Aerodactyl or underestimating it even. But PDC can just go for Soft Boiled and then pivot into Gengar potentially, or make a play predicting Alolan to double on the Gengar or something like that. So I don't know. Rock Slide might be the play. Just Rock Slide and fish for the flinch. just do what Aerodactyl does best, because this mon's filthy. But if it's Fire Blast, like Fire Blast Toxic, or even if it doesn't have the Fire Blast, it doesn't necessarily need that. But if it's that set, this actually just goes in. If it's like Fire Blast Toxic, Soft Boiled, some filler move. The filler move doesn't really matter. But if it's that set, it can actually just really go in on Alolan's team. But he goes into Skarmory, as the Dugtrio does come out from PDC. So he just decided to sack Dugtrio as Alolan gets his Skarmory in, which is pretty nice. He can Whirlwind out here. The Dugtrio can't do shit to the Skarmory, obviously. Like, what's he gonna do? Rock Slide and do a solid, like, 25 or something. So I assume he's just gonna Whirlwind him out. Or go for the Hard Jolt-Back. Yeah, Hard Jolt-Back is a good play as well. I don't know if that was a roll to kill with the Sand. But he lives at 2%, so I don't know, it might be. This Gengar can do some damage, especially if it's T-Bolt to the Skarmory, but not like Alolan has a switch in, so I assume he's just going to stay in and go for that Jolt Back and just take the hit like a man. As PDC goes for Taunt, which is a weird play in my opinion, because Jolt Back was pretty obvious, at least that's what I thought. So, unless he's like set up T-Tar and he just wants to set up, but Taunt doesn't... Yeah, Taunt's only like a few turns, so I don't know, Taunt's only 3 turns. So, I don't even think T-Tar can beat Skarmory 1-on-1. So, yeah, I don't know about that. I guess he wanted the Taunt to prevent the Whirlwind with when he sent out the T-Tar. If this is like special Fire Blast, that can be kind of cool. That can do a fat amount to Skarmory. And the best thing it can do back is Jolt Peck. So, Alolan could go into the Swampert because it doesn't really do that much at this amount of HP. So yeah, I assume he's just going to sack the Swampert here, scouting for Fire Blast in the process, but he goes to the DD. So this is a bit scary, but he can definitely just sack the Swampert. I'm saying he a lot, and with he, I mean both PDC and Alolan at some turns, so I'm sorry, that might be a bit annoying. But Alolan could just sack the Swampert, then go into Skarmory to Whirlwind him out, or even, yeah, no, Whirlwind's definitely play after that. There's really no other play. I guess he can go Celebi and do something, but yeah, that's not the play. He can go into Skarmory, ruin that boy out into, into either Dugtrio or Blissey. And if this is not Fire Blast Blissey, I think Alolan just wins this. So yeah, I kind of made some new mistakes here. I said, like, PDC was going to win, and then I said Alolan was going to win. I don't know. I don't know with me, dude. But, we're probably going to see a Skarmory hit the battlefield. I don't know why Alolan's taken that long. It's kind of weird to me. I think it's the only play, and just hope you don't get flinched, right? Like, I don't really see another play, because Aerodactyl's just going to get... Oh, actually, Aerodactyl is just going to get killed after the T-Tar should live an attack, or not, maybe? Maybe T-Tar actually doesn't live the live the hit from the Aerodactyl. So yeah, I guess Aerodactyl is the play, but it's taking a bit long to Calyx, so I could make a ghosting joke here, but I don't want to get jumped on my neck by like 10 million people. People get like so triggered if you say, oh, they're ghosting, they must be ghosting, and like, I don't know, it's, in my opinion, ghosting is just a joke. Like, if you ghost in a tournament, like, if you ghost in like OST finals, right, it's about the money, I guess, I kind of understand, but like, if you ghost your friends for like some untour, and like, if it's like, and then you start, oh, okay, if you ghost people, that's alright, but if you ghost and then start bragging about your win, ooh, that's the most filthy thing ever, dude. And then when they get exposed, they're like, oh, and they have like 10 million excuses all lined up, they whip out their diary full of excuses, and they just start listing them all. That's the, ooh, those are the most filthy ones known to man, dude. So I assume this is actually, it does live, yeah. So it's just gonna live in DD up, so I don't know if that was the play then. Now he's going to just sack off his Celebi, which is the correct play, yeah. He's just going to sack off the Celebi. If PDC predicted that and went for another DD, that would have been so fire. That would have been mega, mega fire. He's going to taunt, so it's Tauntar. Okay, well, in that case, in that case, I actually do agree with Alolan's. Well, then it didn't really matter. Yeah, thinking about it, I don't know if it... I guess Alolan's play was fine then, yeah. If you predicted Taunt DD, but... I guess he did just predict that, but he just gets flinched, and he does just take the L home. So, kind of weird at the end. Yeah, I guess it did make sense that he wanted to get the damage first and then started Joel pecking, but in my opinion, he should have just went off the fact that, dude, this is some un-English. He should have just gone off the fact that it isn't taunt, because if he taunts, he loses 100%. Yeah, so I guess he should have just gone off that, dude. My English is like top tier, dude. It is top one. So now I can just kill him with two, unless he misses the rock slide here. Should be fine. Even if he does miss the rock slide, should be fine. So, I've said this in multiple variations of the English language a couple times, but in my opinion, Alolan should have just gone off the fact that it wasn't DD taunt. Dark, because that just won right there. So yeah, definitely well played by both. I definitely think Alolan made some powerful plays by doubling in the Skarmory, getting up a spike, then predicting the Gengar to double out, and then getting up another spike. So those are like some highlight plays, in my opinion. I think both players definitely played well. I didn't really see any misplays, and even if I did see any misplays, I'm not saying shit, dude. I'm not trying to criticize these goats. So yeah, definitely well played game. I actually really enjoyed this game. This T-Tar just coming in the end just to molest everyone. So yeah, that's just the power of T-Tar. Yeah, looking at Alolan's team, nice no DD taunt T-Tar answers outside of nice big Swampert. So yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Leave a nice like.